¿Qué pasa?
I'm sister number
two. So we're on our way to Ponchos after.
Ponchos Nuevo, Mexican restaurant, McAllen, Texas.
Am I going the right way?
Yeah, you turn to McAllen.
I turn on McAllen? So this 6:38 p.m. traffic is horrible in McAllen, the McAllen area.
McAllen?
What should we talk about? Let's talk about loneliness. Nobody wants to feel lonely. That's why they run to people, to external distractions. It can either be a human or an object. Don't get loneliness confused with love when you find someone. What I mean by that is when you're lonely and you go find somebody, they comfort your loneliness, therefore you think you love them. Slip right in. That's what she said. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
Hey, you need some air time. Get in. There you go.
I could see that.
You can see what?
Like,
can you relate? Has it happened to you?
Yeah, I've been in a relationship. Because, like, to find comfort, to just be with them. Not really that I was, like, eventually you fall in love, right. But I could never say, yes, I love you. And I've never been the first one to say that I love you. It's always been my partner to be the first one to say, I love you. And from there, I'll ask why.
And why do you love me?
Yeah, why do you love me? Because if you're gonna respond by saying I love you because of physical features or because of just, like, if you love someone just because of their physical features and you don't name anything that's not physical about them, then could you really call that love? Like, you're really just in love with their appearance, not with who they are. So that's something that I had learned. I don't know if it was in class or if it was just like watching videos, but when you ask someone why they love you, you always want to, like, think about, could you name at least 5 things that is not based off of their physical appearance as to why you think you love them?
Yeah.
It could be based off of their personality, the way they treat you, the way they present themselves, like, things like that.
Another thing is, whenever they ask you why do you love this person, a lot of us like to say, because she makes me happy, because she gets along with my family, because she cooks for me. It's like, hold up, this person you love doesn't have to feed you, doesn't have to work full time to keep you happy. You gotta make yourself happy. So instead of saying because she makes me happy,
or because they make me laugh,
like,
or they understand.
You're making it seem like this person has to work to make you this. That's when we start to lose ourselves, because if that person is not in the room, then we can no longer laugh. You know what I mean? We
kind of become like dependent on them.
You become dependent on them. And that's why when people break up,
it hurts.
We freak out. It feels like you lost someone.
First boyfriend. one putting in all the effort, you know, just doing so much. And, you know, it really didn't make me happy, but it made me happy because he was happy.
You were focusing so much on his happiness and not on your own. I could see that. I could see that happening. I mean, it's happened to me before where I wasn't happy with myself, and therefore I would take it out of my partner. Like, I would just attack because I wasn't happy. I was just so insecure with everything of myself. And then I was like, hold up.
Wait a minute.
I'm pretty cool.
You're there.
I'm okay. And then, like, I started to accept myself, to love myself. And then I decided to attract all these awesome people, and now I have a beautiful girlfriend. And we equally put in the effort in this relationship. It's not like you, or me. It's like, no. It's us. We talk. We discuss. We express. The ego is left at the door. I don't care if you have a terrible trait because you're whatever. That is left at the door in the relationship. There is no ego in talking. If you have a child, oh my goodness, a lot of people want to get pregnant, but they don't think about the responsibilities it comes with. Did you talk about the parenting style? Did you talk about your religious beliefs? Like, do you guys have the same beliefs? If not, is it going to affect the child? Are you financially ready? Do you have a backup babysitter? Are you going to be able to balance your relationship, your work, and your child? Do you know? Where are we going?
I had learned this in class. We were talking about relationships, and you know, there's those couples that have kids, and they're all about parenting and their parenting styles, and sometimes they forget to be a couple. They forget to be a couple, and that's when it starts to deteriorate. They forget how they met. They forget how to be lovers and just focus on being parents.
Yeah.
And if you forget how to be lovers, then you know, that could affect your parenting styles, too.
Not only your parenting style, the child gets affected. You know, a lot of these couples don't want to get divorced because they want to stay together for the kid. And it's like, you know, you're showing your kid the wrong way to love because y'all are not even happy. And as long as you guys want to pretend, we can feel that vibe. Everybody can feel the vibe in the room like, oh, that couple, they fucking hate each other. They pretending. Alright guys, where are we at our destination? We are at Poncho's. We are about to eat. Maybe drink. No, not drink because I'm driving. Don't drink and drive.
I'll drink.
Ha! We'll see you guys next time. Bye!